Good morning to all. Hope you all are fine. Today we are going to start our sixth block, that is more about insect. Okay? In previous block we learned about vertebrates and invertebrates. Okay, what are vertebrates? Yes, animal with the backbone are called vertebrates. What are invertebrates? Animal without backbone are called invertebrates. Okay, so what are the examples for invertebrates? Cockroach, earthworm, spider, and okay, enough. These animals do not have backbone. In this block, we are discussing about insect. Do you know insects? Okay, say some names of insects. Yes, and moth, then dragonfly, then butterfly, okay, enough. These are some kinds of insect you can see everywhere, isn't it? So today we are going to study the body parts of insect. Okay, so this image shows that body parts of insect. Look at this picture. What are the body parts you can see from this picture? Yes, head, thorax, abdomen, then eyes, antennae, and legs. All of you draw this diagram in your notebook and label it clearly. Okay, how many legs does an insect have? Insects have 6 legs. How many antennas you can see from this picture? Yes, 1 pair of antennae and 2 eyes, isn't it? These are the body parts of an insect. Okay, is they are similar with the human beings body part? Yes, because we have head, insect also have head. We have eyes, insect also have eyes. We have legs, insect also have legs. In these aspects, they are similar to us. They have antennae that attached to the head. They have eyes that located on head, and they have wings that attached to the thorax, and they have 3 pair of legs attached to the thorax, and they have an abdomen. Did you get the idea? These are the body parts of an insect. Commonly, the body parts of insects divided into 3, that is head, thorax, and abdomen. Commonly, insects body part divided into 3, that is head, thorax, and abdomen. Caterpillars have many body parts, isn't it? Are caterpillars are insects? Why or why not? Caterpillars are young ones of butterfly. It is the growing stage of butterfly, isn't it? So in this time, 3 parts not clearly visible. When it grow into butterfly, we can see that these 3 parts: head, thorax, and abdomen. So caterpillar is an insect. Okay, so all of you open your workbook, S1, block 6, S1. First question: label these body parts of the insects: eyes, legs, head, thorax, abdomen, and wings. So all of you label these body parts in this given insects. Which are the insects given here? Yes, dragonfly and bed bug. Okay, second question: caterpillar has many body parts. Why is it called an insect? We already discussed here, caterpillar is a young one of butterfly. So in growing stage, that 3 body parts will not see clearly. So when it grow, that 3 parts become visible. Okay, so all of you do block 6 practice question 1 and 2 and worksheet S1. Okay, next we are going to discuss about different insects. We learned that insects body is divided into 3 parts, which are the head, thorax and abdomen, isn't it? So I hope all of you understood that. Then we are going to discuss about different insects. What are the other ways in which they are different? So let us know about that, isn't it? So we are so all of you read textbook page number 32 and 33. 5 kinds of insects are mentioned in your textbook, isn't it? Which are they? Okay, dragonfly, moths, silverfish, very good, bed bug, okay, then fleas, okay. What did you learn from the reading? Okay, in your textbook, these 5 insects are mentioned in your textbook, isn't it? So we are going to study where they live, what they eat, all other things. Okay, we are going to discuss similarities and dissimilarities of these insects. Okay, first one, dragonfly. Okay, where do dragonfly live? Dragonfly live near ponds, lake and streams. Okay, what kind of food they are eating? They are eating ant, mosquito and other small insects. How long do they live? Different types of dragonfly lives for different period of time. Okay, next which insect given? Yes, that is moths. Moths is looking like butterfly, isn't it? Where they live? They are found on garden, open grassy area and forest. What they eat? Nectar. They eat nectar. The young ones feed on leaves. Young ones feed on leaves. Okay, the different types of moths live for different period of time. Next, which insect is given here? Yes. Yes, what is that? Silverfish. Okay, where you can see this silverfish? Yes, we can see them in behind table. They are found in books and clothes and behind the table. Okay, so what is its lifespan? They live in between 2 to 8 years. They live in between 2 to 8 years. Okay, next, bed bugs. Okay, bed bugs found on bird, or they are live on bird, and it eats or it drinks human blood, human or other animals' blood. And the lifespan of bird bug is 10 months after hatching. Come to the next insect, that is fleas. Fleas are live on animal's body. Fleas are live on animal's body. Animals like dog, cat and birds. And they suck or they drink blood of these animals. What are the ways? They are different. Yes, they are living in different place. They eat different kinds of things. And some insects are active at night and some insects are active at daytime. The insect that active at night is called nocturnal insect. they are active at night. Okay, nocturnal insect. And some insects are helpful to us. Some insects are help to us and some insects are harmful to us. Okay, some insects are helpful to us and some insects are harmful to us. Okay, what are the insects helpful to us? For example, dragonfly. Okay, dragonfly eat mosquito and other small insect. So how this dragonfly helpful to us? Yes, what is that? They eat mosquito, isn't it? They eat mosquito and mosquito is very harmful to us, isn't it? How it is harmful? Because it spread diseases. Mosquito spread malaria, chikungunya, dengue fever. All these kinds of diseases are spread by mosquito. The dragonfly eat these mosquito and it help to protect us from these diseases, isn't it? So the dragonfly is a helpful insect. What about moth? Moth eat nectar and its young one feed on leaves. Moth eat nectar and the young one feed on leaves. Leaves of crops. We farming some kind of plants, isn't it? It eats the leaf of crop. What happen? Crops will damage, isn't it? So moths damage the crops. Is it helpful or harmful? Yes, moth is a harmful insect, isn't it? What about silverfish? Silverfish eat starch and paste used to bind books. It damage the book. Okay, so it is a harmful insect. What about bed bug? It suck human and other animals' blood. It suck human and other animals' blood. So it is it harmful or helpful insect? Yes, it is a harmful insect. Okay, then next, fleas. Fleas are live on animals' body. It drink animals' blood. So it also a harmful insect. It also a harmful insect. Did you get the idea? Okay, some chemicals that used to kill insect, that is called insecticide. Insecticides is used to kill insects. Farmers are using to kill harmful insect, but insecticide kill all insects. All insects are killed by insecticide. It is a chemical. Okay, so insecticide is a chemical that used to kill insects. Okay, did you get the idea? Okay, may I ask one question? Farmers using insecticides to kill harmful insects. Okay, that kills moth which damage crops. This insecticide also kill dragonfly. How can killing of dragonfly is harmful to us? Farmer using insecticide to kill harmful insect like moth which damage crops. And this insecticide also kill dragonfly. Insecticide can kill all insect. So dragonfly also killed by this insecticide. How can killing of dragonfly is harmful to us? Because dragonfly is a helpful insect, isn't it? That eat mosquito. Mosquito spread deadly diseases, isn't it? Mosquito spread deadly diseases. So dragonfly eat these mosquitoes. When the insecticide kills the dragonfly, mosquito will increase and the cases of disease also increase. All of you open your workbook S2. First one, name the insects and complete the table. Okay, First one, first question, name the insect and complete the table. Okay, what is the first insect given here? Yes, dragonfly. Very good. So where do they live? They live near pond, lake and streams. Okay, then what do they eat? They eat ant, mosquito and other small insects. Okay, clear? Okay, then how long do they live? Different types of dragonfly live for different period of time. Okay, how do they harm or help us? They are helpful to us, or they help by eating mosquito. Which is the next insect? Yes, it is a moth, isn't it? It is a moth. Where do they live? They live on garden, forest and open grassy area, isn't it? Okay, then what do they eat? They eat nectar and young one feed on leaves. Young one feed on leaves. How long do they live? How long do they live? Different types of moths live for different period of time. Okay. How do they harm or help us? They are harm or help us? Yes, they are harmful. Isn't it? They are harmful insects. It damage crops. Okay. It damage crops. So this is a harmful insect. Next, which kind of insect is given here? Yes, silverfish. Where do they live? They live in books and clothes, then behind the table. They are live in all the books, behind the table and clothes. Okay, what do they eat? Yes, they eat starch and paste used to bind the books. Okay, how long do they live? They live in between 2 to 8 years. They live in between 2 to 8 years. How do they harm or help us? They damage books. This is a harmful insect. Okay, do you understand? So what is the next insect? Yes, bed bug. Where do they live? They live on bed. Okay, what do they eat? They drink human and other animals' blood. How long do they live? They live for 10 months after hatching. How do they harm or help us? They suck our blood. That is why it is a harmful insect. Okay. So next one. Next insect is flea. Next insect is flea. Where do they live? They live on animal's body. They live on animal's body. What do they eat? They drink blood of these animals. They drink blood of these animals. How long do they live? They live in between 1 to 3 years after hatching. How do they harm or help us? How do they harm or help us? It drinks animals' blood and it is a harmful insect. I hope all of you understood about these 5 insects. Okay, so let's discuss next question. Question number 2. Why is too much use of insecticides and pesticides discouraged? Too much use of insecticides and pesticides kill the insects which helpful to us. Okay, that is why too much use of pesticides and insecticides are discouraged. Okay, so all of you do practice question 3 and 4 and complete your S2. I hope all of you understood today's class. You read your textbook again and do your works today itself. Okay, so let us wind up our today's class and take care. Thank you.